Installment number 5 of Drugstore Beauty Brand Superstars is coming at you right now. Hi friends, welcome into installment number 5 of Beauty Brand Superstars, where I show you the best of the best of the brands that are at the drugstore, and I pick out for you the very cream of the crop to take out the guesswork when you go shopping. So there are 4 videos before this, which I will link below in a playlist so you can go back and see those. Today we're going to be going over Koki Cosmetics, ColourPop, and Makeup Revolution. And I can't wait to show you what I found. All right, we're gonna start with Koki right away. But before we do, I do wanna tell you that my earrings are not available. I have had these earrings probably for 15 years. I don't remember where I got them, but I get asked about them every time I wear them on camera. So that's that. And then my top I got at Ross, and you might still be able to get it. It's kind of springy and bright. And all of my makeup will be listed down below along with all of these products. Okay, we're starting out with Koki. Koki is one of those brands that I really think is a hidden gem at the drugstore. You can't get them at too many drugstores. I know that Rite Aid does carry them. And then Sally Beauty actually carries them now too, which I think is great. And probably the most standout product for me is this foundation, which is the Full Cover Foundation. It's what I have on today. I actually really love this foundation. It covers so well and it goes really good on my mature skin. It is a little bit more heavy. So if you're somebody that likes a lighter feeling foundation, it's actually one that I wear more in the winter time. You know, as I get into the summer, I kind of lighten up the texture as well as, you know, darkening the color of my foundation. This one I did have to color correct, and I think I have this in 20C or cool, but this foundation wears so pretty on my skin. It will be there all day long. It won't have any break apart. I don't have a problem with that. I do use a very small amount, and then if I need to, I go in areas where I just kind of need a little bit extra. So because it is a little bit more dense of a formula, you need to use a whole lot less, which I don't mind. The foundation itself has a pump and it has this gold accents. I love it when they do a really nice drugstore foundation that looks high end. And so here's the foundation right here, and you can see how well it's going to cover. It's just a really great foundation for that. And like I said, this isn't a great color for me. I do color correct, but this is a really nice foundation as far as it doesn't dry me out. I do have dry skin. As you can see, it's a little bit matte. It's not super matte though, and I do like that about it. So this is a foundation that I would say works really good for me. And if you want to try it out, it's not going to break the bank. Also from Koki, I love their lip liners. And today I do have one of them on. Let me see which one I have on. The one that I have on is Plum Purple. And this is just a silky formula, like a gel formula. It goes on really well. It blends if you want to blend it into your color, which is what I did today, and mix your colors. It blends so well. And then the other one that I have, they're both Plum Purple. I picked up those, but I do like the other one that is kind of the deepened red, but I love this. It goes on really smoothly. It blends in really well. It gives you a little bit of definition on your lips, and it doesn't bleed out into my lines, which I have vertical lines, which I really like about it. So I do like that one. And then also the last product I have from Koki is their cream highlighter. Oh my goodness, this is so pretty. I think this one is rose something. Let me see if I can figure it out. It's rosy. So this is a cream product, which I think it's just beautiful. I do have this on as my highlighter today. It's one of those highlighters that I just think is so nice and so pretty on skin. And this one particularly, I will pull this back so you guys can see a little bit better. It is a rosy color. They did have a gold, and I believe they had like just a light color too. I'm not sure. They might just have the gold and this one. But it's really silky, really smooth. It lasts a long time, doesn't show up any texture, and really plays well under blush and over foundation. So really love those products from Koki. The next brand that we're going to talk about is Makeup Revolution. I started out absolutely loving Makeup Revolution's eyeshadows, and then somewhere in there they just changed their formula, and that all changed for me. But they do still have really pretty complexion products, and so I have a few here that I really like. I actually also want to mention the hydrating formula of their foundation. I haven't tried the glow formula, so if you've tried that, let me know in the comments what that's like. But the hydrating formula of their foundation is really good, and I actually just tossed that out like about a month ago when I did a declutter, because I had had it for like 2, maybe almost 3 years. So I really needed, and it was separating and all that. So I really needed to get rid of that. But here's the other complexion products that I have that I like. I recently put this one in a dupes video. Actually, I have two of these in here that were in a dupes video. This one is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Fix Ultimate Coverage Concealer with Salicylic Acid. And this one is in light beige. This is a dupe for the Kevin Aucoin, I can't remember what it's called right now. It is super duper creamy, super emollient. A teeny tiny bit goes a long way. That might even do your whole face, how much I just put on there. Seriously, it is that thick of a concealer. But what's beautiful about it is that emollient consistency. So it's not going to dry down and make you look like you have really super dry under eyes. It is absolutely gorgeous as far as how it covers. It's fantastic. I just really love everything about it. And what I will say is go watch that video, because I talked about how you have to use this. If you don't use just a minuscule amount of it, I mean, even like the tip of a toothpick or something, you will get too much and you won't like it. I also do really like the Infinite formula and the hydrating formula of their concealers. Both of these, again, have fantastic coverage. Now, these both of these formulas are a little lighter. The Infinite one is a little bit more along the matte side. So if you do have a little bit of breakthrough and kind of an oily underneath your eyes, some people do, then this one that is the Infinite one probably would be a really good one for you. The hydrating one is just a little bit more along those properties of being hydrating enough that it doesn't, you know, really make you look super dried out. Again, if I'm talking concealers anytime with anybody, I'm going to tell you, use tiny, tiny amounts of product. And even if it's some like this that are more on the creamy side than the emollient side, I tell you, use less. Less is always more when your concealer and your foundation are concerned, and then you won't get so much product breakthrough. And then a product that I did compare to Charlotte Tilbury's, her Flawless Filter Primer. This is the Fix and Glow Ultra Glow Primer. And this is not exactly the color of those. This is a little bit more pink, but when you get it underneath any sort of foundation, you're gonna find that it's just a beautiful primer. I do have it underneath mine today. When you have a super matte foundation, that's when these come in and they do give you just a tiny bit of that glow. They will show through if you don't have a super high coverage foundation. This one is a little bit more higher coverage, but you can still see that this shows through just a tiny bit. This is a beautiful primer, and as I'm feeling it right here, I can feel that it has a tiny bit of the dimethicone or the silicone base to it, so it's still going to fill in your pores and kind of even out your complexion at the same time. But doesn't that hand look pretty? It really does look pretty as far as this other one that doesn't have anything on it. So you can tell that it's going to kind of really help boost your complexion. I really like that. And then lastly, I am wearing their mascara, and this is the Lift and Define 5D Lash Extra Dimension Mascara. Makeup Revolution did send this to me, so I do thank them. And that is the wand right there. It is not a plastic wand. It's the natural bristles, and then it just tapers up to the end. I do like that it's a little skinnier than what we're seeing out right now. I have, you know, really shaky hands, and so to put a fat wand on my eyelashes, I'm going to inevitably dot this stuff somewhere. So I really do appreciate the skinnier wand, and I do feel like it really builds up, and it really does define my lashes, and hopefully you'll be able to see. My lashes are a little bit thin right now. They're long, but they're a little bit thin. So I like how this builds up. I like the length that it gives. The only concern I have with this really, truly is that in the process of building, you can only put one coat on. Don't go in and put another coat on immediately because you're going to get them kind of clumping together a little bit. After it dries for a second, you can go in and put on a second coat and then tip them to make them look longer. But yeah, that's the only thing I have to say that might be a little bit negative about it, but it's a really good mascara and I've been using it like crazy. It even went made itself into my mascara video that I did. I tested like 30 mascaras in a year and this made it into one of the top ones. So you know that this is a really good mascara. Okay, now on to ColourPop. ColourPop is one of those companies that has just come onto the scene as an indie brand and it's just broken up everything. It's just completely broken up the industry, I feel like, because of their price point and because of their quality. And I started out way back when using ColourPop and their Super Shock formula and fell in love. Every time I get into a highlighter or a favorites or anything like that video or cream video, I'm talking about the Super Shock formula. And one of those things is the Super Shock highlighters. I wish they would start coming back out again with their bronzers and their contours that has this, because this formula is something really special. This one is called Stole the Show. I make sure that I put my lids back on really tight because this is a cream formula that will have a tendency to dry out on you. Now, you can, even though it might separate from the pan, I will say that you can just go and put your finger in there. It's still going to be a good product. It's just that they don't last more than about a year, so you know that, but they're worth it. Look at that highlighter. Holy cow, that one stole the show. And then we're going to go in with Flexitarian is the next one I have. This is my favorite one. And Flexitarian is what I have on my inner corner today. But it's my favorite one. It's like a champagne-y, pretty color that just looks good with just about any coloring. And then Stole the Show is like a pinky peach almost, I would say. It's one of those colors that's just... Oh, I love this one. And it's very light. It's not as beaming as the other two. So you're not going to have quite as much light from it or quite as much reflect from it, but you're definitely going to have the glow from it. So those are the Super Shock highlighters. And I think they're just gorgeous. They hug the cheeks. They work into mature skin so beautifully. And they never show up any texture for me. So that highlighter has been a favorite of mine for a very long time. Now, when they did come out with the Super Shock blushes, which I think was their second product, so the Super Shock eyeshadow, which I don't have any in here today, but then it was the blushes, and holy moly, these are so good. I love these. I have a couple that I have hit pan on. This is called Between the Sheets. This is probably my favorite color because it can go with anything that you're wearing. It's a very pinky peach color. It's along the lines of that rose, natural, just your flush look on your cheeks. I think it's so beautiful. And then we have the Prenup, which is definitely more along the lines of a mauve rose. And this is another one I've hit pan on. Beautiful color. This is the one I do have on today, which I probably will pop a little bit more on there for you so you can see just a little bit. Beautiful rosy color on that one. And I will go ahead and just pop just a tiny bit of that on there on those cheeks for you so you can just see it a little bit more. It's so pretty and it blends in so seamlessly. I mean, my goodness, just absolutely gorgeous. Never shows up any texture. The last one I have is my more peach option, which is Count Me In. Gorgeous peach color that is so good for the spring and summer. They're all beautiful for spring and summer, but you can tell right there that they have a really good selection of them. They have some that are deeper and I love them. They can be built up. They can be sheared out. They're just a gorgeous product. So yes, Super Shock blushes. Absolutely love them. Probably my number one product from ColourPop. And then also in a recent video, I talked about colored eyeliners and how much I'm enjoying those. I do have this blue color right here, which is crazy. CRZY is the color on their website and on Ulta. It's like a cross between a navy and sapphire blue, and I've just been using those across my lash line on the top to bring definition, but also to bring a fun pop of color without going too crazy. And then this one right here is the brown one, and I don't remember what the brown one is called. I just smudged the crap out of that other one. So once you have them there, they're going to dry down. They're going to be there for the whole entire day. You're not gonna have to worry about them. I will say that they're pretty juicy when you first get them. You can see right there that there's a lot of ink in there, but you can, you know, go in with a really light touch and get a really great line there as well. And I don't know if you can really even tell that I have on a blue on the top of my eyes or not, but it's so much fun for me to do that. And I just have really enjoyed having these particular liners because they have some really pretty colors. So you might check out also what's on their website for other colors. They have a lot on Ulta though too. And then one of my favorite things that they have is their pencils, their lippy pencils. I think this is a great formula. It's very much like the Cokie formula in the creaminess that it has, that you can blend it with your lipstick and it just blends in like a dream, because these are, I believe these are a gel formula too, and I'm gonna have a hard time seeing this because they put their, okay, this one's called Shot Clock. And this one is kind of a nude rose color, a medium rose color. So it would be really pretty on somebody that had lighter coloring. I was gonna show you three, but I can't show you this one because it's been discontinued for a long time. This one is Lumiere. And this one was the one that Kathleen Lights chose this color. This is probably my favorite color ever, and they don't have it anymore. But Lumiere was one of those ones that I wanted to show on air today, because if you're ever on any of their social media, ColourPops, and they say, would you like us to bring any colors back? Lumiere in the lippy pencil is a must. It's one of those colors that I can wear all over my lips, and it's a beautiful mauve-y, rosy pink color that I just wish that they'd bring back, because look how little my pencil's getting. I love that stuff. And then the last thing we're gonna talk about are their shadows. And I have a few suggestions for you for palettes if you're somebody that hasn't gotten into this before. The Stone Cold Fox palette came out a while ago, and it is a palette that has a lot of cool tones in it. And I love that they are looking to cool tones now, because for such a long time, all of the eyeshadows were warm. But this palette takes you into a little bit of warmth, but a little bit of cool too. And so I really have appreciated using this one. It has some gorgeous lighter colors, which is so nice for me too, because sometimes the palette can get too dark really fast, and I won't be able to find a color that I can use as a light color. This color right down here at the bottom, I'm going to pull back because sometimes these are hard to see, but right here, this is a color that I have across my lids. And then I used another palette today that I will show you here in just a second, but the colors are great in here, yes, but the formula is very easily blendable too. You do have a tiny bit of kick up. I'm not going to tell you that that's not there, but at the same time, they work as eyeshadows so well because they do have a great amount of saturation, and they do also blend very easily. Their mattes aren't like super buttery, but they're a pretty, pretty formula that's very easy to work with. And I think that that's the standout about their shadows. The next two are kind of neutral favorites of mine. Well, I actually have three that are neutral favorites. The one that they had that is Going Coconuts, that is kind of, if you want to talk more along the lines of a neutral palette, it's still got a lot of warmth to it. When somebody says neutral, I want it to be something that is very easily worn for somebody that loves pinks, and very easily worn for somebody that loves corals. So this fits the bill for a lot of that. I really like that they didn't throw any of the glitter in here. That's one of the things that's hard for me. So this palette is really great for that. I love that they went into like a more rosy neutral color. And like I said, this one can get a little bit dark a little bit fast, but this is my saving grace right here, is that bone color right there. Mix it with any of these, it lightens them up immediately. And then that's Taupe. This one is their cool tone palette. This is the one that I do have on today. I actually went in as this one right here is my transition color, mixed with a tiny bit of this, and then I deepened up with these two colors right here. And it just worked out really pretty. I love this palette so much. And then Making Mauves is one of my standbys for the cool tones. And then the mauves that work so good as eyeshadows without getting right stark into purple. And I really think this one is beautiful. Again, we didn't have any of the glitter in here. I love that about it. Now, the last two that I'm gonna show you are the Lilac You A Lot and the Blue Moon palette. And these two palettes came out quite a while ago. And I do love the purple palette. It's my pleasure. Love that palette. But this one in the spring and summer, I tend to go towards because it just has those lighter, springy colors from the purple hue. And plus for me, I'm a little bit lighter skinned, so it helps out a lot. Love this color down here. This is one that works so good in your transition. And then hit the other ones with, you know, your outer V and across the lid, and they're gorgeous. Now, there is a few of these in here that are the Super Shock formula. This one's not, but I did want to show you that one because that is such a bright pink. And I think it's so pretty, just really, really pretty color. And then into the Blue Moon palette, this one is one that completely stole my heart because these blues are so vibrant and so pretty. I love these. Now this one down here, I've heard a lot of people say that they're not crazy about this color. I am. It's a duochrome blue. So it's got that icy quality to it, and then it's got the blue to it as well. I love that. When I get that on my eyelids and I turn and it's just a beautiful reflect of that icy blue color. Very, very pretty. And then today I do have this color on as my liner underneath my eyes, smudged out. I love this periwinkle blue right here. I think that's one of the prettiest shades I've ever seen in a palette for a long time. That blue is, it's just unique because it's almost to the point of being like a light lavender cast in there, but at the same time you still have that almost cornflower blue. So I really love that color. If you do happen to see one that you really enjoy the color scheme of, you might want to go ahead and grab that. Okay, that's it for today. If there's anything in these brands that you absolutely love, let me know in the comment section below because I'm always looking for new products to try. And I thank you for tuning in today and spending a bit of your day with me. Please stay happy, stay healthy, stay sanitized, and stay safe out there. I love you very much. Catch you in my next video. Bye, friends.